Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Nate. Thank you for joining me today on The King of Random. Here in the studio, we love a good science experiment. I've learned about a good one recently that I want to try out. It's very simple, but should be fun. Some of you may be familiar with a movie called October Sky about a boy named Homer Hickam who loves building rockets. The movie is based off of a book called Rocket Boys, and it explains that one of the fuels that Homer tested out was a mixture of zinc powder and sulfur. The mixture of zinc powder and sulfur is supposed to burn very quickly and with a very bright flash, so we're going to try and replicate that today in the studio using materials we can easily get our hands on. A cheap and easy source of zinc is pennies. Pennies look like they're made of copper, but since 1982, that's just been a thin coating on the outside. They're actually made 97.5% out of zinc. Obviously, for a mixture with only two ingredients, there's not a lot of supplies you need. First is some sulfur powder. This is a dusting sulfur which is used as a fungicide and insecticide on plants. You can pick this up in your local gardening store. The ingredients list this as 90% sulfur, so it's not pure, but I've read that it will work for this experiment. The second ingredient is zinc, which, as I explained, we're gonna try filing down some pennies to get a nice zinc powder. And lastly, I have a metal file, which I'm going to use to grind down the pennies. Hopefully, I'll get a fine enough powder that it will burn. Our first step is to take some pennies and start filing. Now let's tape a piece of paper to the side of our clamp so we don't lose all of our filings. There we go. That doesn't look super pretty, but it should be very functional. I've now ground up quite a bit of zinc from our pennies, so let's put it on our scale and see how much we've got. Our scale says we have 5.4 grams of zinc powder, which is a little bit more than the weight of two pennies. I've seen a few different mix ratios of the zinc and sulfur that are supposed to work as a flash powder. I'm going to try 1:1 for the first test. All right, we've got 1 gram of our zinc powder. Now let's add 1 gram of our sulfur. Okay, I've now got 2 grams of our 1:1 mix of zinc and sulfur powder. Zinc fumes are not good to breathe in though, so I am gonna try lighting this off outside. Now, I'm not sure how sensitive this stuff is. In theory, if you've got a fine grain mixture, it can even light off with static electricity, so it's a good idea to be very careful with it. However, I think that our filings from the pennies are gonna be a larger grain and might be a little bit harder to ignite. So I'm going to start by trying a barbecue lighter, and then a few other things if that doesn't work. Oh, it's doing something. I wonder if it's just burning the sulfur a little bit. It's not very dark out here, so you can't see, but I think the sulfur itself might have caught on fire. Okay, that smoke rising right now I think means it just went out. All right, the barbecue lighter didn't work, so let's go on to try using a little bit of fuse to see if the higher heat from the fuse will get it to ignite.
Oh, wow, look at that. The bit that burned before just kind of comes off as a shell. So yeah, I think the zinc powder melted together but wouldn't light. That's interesting.
I'm gonna use the scissors to hold the fuse down because otherwise it sort of tends to take off like a mini rocket. Kind of like that. Nothing. Again, I think we got some melted zinc, and I think the sulfur has caught on fire again. Can you see a little bit of that blue flame in there? There it is. Yep, so that's the sulfur caught on fire, but the zinc won't catch on fire. The barbecue lighter didn't work and the fuse didn't work, so I'm gonna try hitting the remaining powder with some map gas out of the blowtorch and see if we can get a reaction out of that. Nothing. Well, that didn't seem to do anything either. I think I've successfully melted all of the zinc and probably burned all of the sulfur, but we didn't get any sort of ignition, nothing that looked like flash powder, nothing that looked like an explosion, so I don't think that this worked very well at all. I'm fairly certain that our problem was the size of the filings of the pennies, so I'm gonna see if I can do something to grind them down even smaller to hopefully get a finer mesh of powder. I've never ground down zinc powder in a mortar and pestle before, but I'm gonna try and see if it works. 4.35 grams of zinc and 4.35 grams of sulfur. I have my doubts that the zinc is a fine enough powder that it will ignite easily, but let's give it a try.
Wow, okay,
that lit.
Yep, that's on fire.
That's more of what we were looking for.
All right, we did get a reaction there. It did light on fire. Now that might have just been because the map gas burns hot enough to ignite zinc powder. I'm not sure if the sulfur made any difference or not, but it did light. It was a cool green flame, so that was maybe a step in a better direction, but I have an idea for how we can test this, at least as a proof of concept.
Depending on the chemical reaction that took place, this is either zinc sulfide or zinc oxide. It's kind of hard to tell which, since I don't know if the sulfur made a difference or not. So we barely got an ignition, and I think the problem is the size of the zinc powder. I'm not able to grind it to a fine enough point where it will really light easily. To test this as a proof of concept, I've gone ahead and bought some commercially available zinc powder, and we'll use that in the mixture to see if it ignites as quickly as we're hoping it will.
2 grams of zinc powder, 2 grams of sulfur powder.
Let's go straight to map gas. Nothing.
Oh, weird, that's like gummy texture almost. It's all squishy, like a squishy sulfur zinc clay. That worked even less. Oh, we got some sulfur burning though, blue flame.
Blue fire from burning sulfur.
All right, I have one more thing we can try. All right, that didn't seem to work any better. In fact, I think it worked less well because we were able to get our other one to light off with the map gas, but not this mixture. I do have one more idea. There are different places that say different ratios that you're supposed to mix this to. I've been trying 1:1 with equal weight of zinc and sulfur, but I've also seen something that says you should use 3 parts zinc to 1 part sulfur. So I'm gonna try that and see if it makes a difference.
All right, there's 3 grams of zinc. And there's 1 gram of sulfur.
All right, this is the 3:1 ratio of the zinc dust to the sulfur. Hopefully this one works out a little better. Whoa!
All right, that was a fast reaction. That all just went up in a cloud all at once. That was really quick. Look at this. You can see it even sprayed the reaction material all over. So this is gonna be zinc sulfide, all of this burned powder that it just like sprayed everywhere. That's pretty cool.
All right, now that was the kind of reaction I was hoping for from the beginning. It went really quick. It even like, it launched itself through the air and you probably couldn't see very well, but there was like this mushroom shaped smoke cloud coming off it. It was pretty great. Let's do that again. Okay, I've mixed up another batch, spread that out on the ground. I've made it into a little bit of a line to see if we get a slightly more delayed or stretched out reaction, but same plan, I'm just gonna hit it with the torch and watch it go.
Wow.
It didn't slow it down pretty much at all to have it spread out. The flame traveled along the line like in an instant. So that stuff has just a crazy amount of flash power to it. Very little noise. I would have thought it would be louder, but it's just sort of a popping sound and just a very bright light and a lot of smoke. But that looks pretty great. I get why you would think that could be used as a rocket fuel. It's very fast burning. One more time.
Cloud kind of came right at me that time. That stuff is really fun. That just goes up, bright green flash, and then big puff of smoke, and it's all gone in an instant and very quiet. There you have it. We've tried mixing zinc powder and sulfur together, and we got some mixed results. When filing down pennies, we couldn't get a small enough grain of zinc for it to really ignite the way we want it to. After grinding the zinc filings in a mortar and pestle for about 10 minutes, we were eventually able to get it to light off by hitting it with a map gas torch for a little while. That was a cool burn, but it wasn't really the explosive reaction we were hoping for. In the end, we did unfortunately have to go with some commercially available pre-made zinc powder, but when you mix that with sulfur in the right 3:1 ratio, it went off immediately. Those were some really cool, very fast burns. Bright green flame, big puff of smoke. That looked really cool, and I think in the near future, we're going to try and use that same fuel to propel a small rocket. I would still love to be able to make this zinc powder at home, so if you have an idea of how I can make a fine enough zinc powder out of pennies, please let me know in the comments below.
There you have it. Now you know that zinc powder and sulfur can be combined to make a very fast burning mixture that might work as a small rocket propellant. Thanks for joining us for this video today, and we look forward to the next one. Talk to you then. Here you can see we've got a penny from 1974. This one should be almost entirely copper if we file off the edge.
Here's our 1974 penny and our 1983 penny, and you can see the difference when you file down both edges. The penny from 1974 has a copper interior, and the penny from 1983 has a zinc interior.
Hey guys, quick reminder that King of Random t-shirts are available once again. Just go ahead and click the link at the top of the description, and it'll take you to where you can get one today.